After Donovan Mitchell walked into the arena wearing his rookie sweater, I thought, you know what? It's time for me to make a video about this. It's obviously the end of the season. Who's going to be Rookie of the Year? You've read the title. I'm ready for a crazy comment section. It's going to get heated down there, but that's okay. I will stick by my opinion at the start of 2 years ago when I made my video saying Ben Simmons is the next LeBron James. Yeah, I said in that video he wasn't going to be LeBron James, but he'll be the next LeBron James just as LeBron James is the next Magic Johnson. And I'm standing by it. I feel like Ben Simmons, going through the past history of the NBA, is the Rookie of the Year. Yes, Ben Simmons was on a team last year. I understand that. But he didn't play a game, which means he classifies as a Rookie of the Year. And he is deserving of the Rookie of the Year this year. I don't feel like if you come out and you say, well, he's not a rookie, that just diminishes his achievements, because it doesn't. That just means that, well, you think he's not a rookie, but based on NBA history, he is a rookie. Like, it doesn't really have any effect. Obviously, Donovan Mitchell's definition of a rookie is quite true. It is a current player playing for his first season as a member of a professional sports team. The thing is, though, Ben Simmons is playing in his first season of his team. I mean, he's playing in his first season. He didn't play last year. So if the argument is if he didn't play in his first year, he doesn't really have much of an argument, because Ben Simmons is about a 16-point game, 8 assist and 8 rebound player. In fact, he's the second player in league history to record at least 1.2 thousand points, 600 assists and 600 rebounds in a season. But then you have Donovan Mitchell. He leads all rookies in scoring at 20.5 points per game. And in fact, he broke the record for the most three-pointers made by a rookie at 186. Both players are incredible. And if it was up to me, honestly, I would say it should be a co-rookie of the year. And the reason I didn't want to just make a video on why it's going to be a co-rookie of the year is because you can just say, oh, I think they're going to be co-rookie of the year, and then not really have an argument because, well, they both deserve to win Rookie of the Year. So if you actually choose a player and you stick with an argument for that player, I guess it just makes the video a little bit more enjoyable. But if it was up to me, I'd say yes, co-Rookie of the Year. But if it isn't that way, here's why Ben Simmons will win the Rookie of the Year. There have only been a few co-Rookie of the Years. In 1970 to 71, it was Dave Cowens and Petrie. In 1994 and 95, it was Grant Hill and Jason Kidd. In 1999 and 2000, it was Elton Brand and Steve Francis. And in my opinion, in 2018, it will be Ben Simmons and Donovan Mitchell. I feel like this is one of those that is just way too hard to compare. Ben Simmons is one of the greatest rookies of all time. Donovan Mitchell is one of the greatest rookies of all time. Well, arguably. Donovan Mitchell is having a great season, but Ben Simmons is actually historic. He's doing things that have only really been done by Magic Johnson and the likes of LeBron James. In fact, if you average 15 points, which he has, 8 assists, which he has, and 8 rebounds, which he has, including one steal, which he did, that would make him the first rookie ever in NBA history to do that. So historically, he is one of the greatest rookies of all time in that area. But by the same token, Mitchell is historic in the fact that he set the most three-pointers by a rookie of all time with 186. And obviously, he is the first rookie since David Robinson with the Spurs to be a leading scorer on his team with at least 46 wins. And I feel like we should start on the fact that Ben Simmons is that good that people are now starting to say, oh, hang on a minute, he didn't play in his first rookie year, so he shouldn't be a rookie at all. Because when Blake Griffin won it, when he was injured in his first season, no one said anything, or maybe a few people said, but majority of people didn't say. In fact, last year, when Joel Embiid was considered a rookie, even though he sat out for 2 years, no one really said it, apart from a few people. The only thing that people said was, he didn't play enough games to win the Rookie of the Year. So Ben Simmons is that good that unless the definition of the Rookie of the Year changes to actual first season in the league, then Ben Simmons will change a rule in the league itself. Ben Simmons is a playmaker. That's what he does. He does facilitate the ball. He's a pass-first player. And he does average about five more assists than Donovan Mitchell. Donovan Mitchell averages 3.7. Ben Simmons averages 8.2. So if assist and rebounding are out the way, Ben Simmons averages more steals at 1.7 compared to 1.5, which isn't much, but it is a fact that he averages more. And Donovan Mitchell is known as a defensive guard. And then blocks per game, Ben Simmons is 6'8", so you'd almost assume that he'd get more blocks. But as we've seen with Dwayne Wade in the past, that's not always the case. Some guards do get more blocks. But for this instance, we're going to say it's clear that Ben Simmons was always going to get more blocks than Donovan Mitchell. He averages about 1. Donovan Mitchell is about 0.3. Keep in mind, and this is pretty awesome, that both players pretty much played the exact amount of games and the exact amount of minutes. Donovan Mitchell played 79 while Ben played 81. And the minutes, well, Ben Simmons played more by only 0.3 minutes per game. So what's the difference here? It's the scoring. Donovan Mitchell obviously is one of the best rookie scorers we've ever seen. He averaged 20.5, whilst Ben Simmons averaged about 16. The thing is though, Ben Simmons did this without shooting any three-pointers. Pretty much any threes throughout the whole entire season. Now that isn't something that you can say, oh well, Ben Simmons wins in that category because he didn't shoot threes, but I'm just saying, Ben Simmons didn't shoot threes. So obviously, three-pointers is more than two-pointers, and when Donovan Mitchell takes 7 three-pointers a game and Ben Simmons takes 0.1, obviously the scoring is going to be a bit of a boost for Donovan Mitchell. But at the exact same time, Donovan Mitchell also took 5 more attempts than Ben Simmons. Donovan Mitchell took 17 attempts, whilst Ben Simmons took 12 field goal attempts, and he still managed to average 16 points per game. I feel like that is saying something right there. I feel like if the only thing that Donovan Mitchell is really better at is his scoring, and Ben Simmons only averaged 4.5 points less than Donovan Mitchell, and without shooting any threes, I feel like if that's the only thing you can say Donovan Mitchell was better at, then Ben Simmons is the Rookie of the Year. I mean, there's not really anything else you could say. Obviously, the story is incredible for Donovan Mitchell. If you're going to base it off the storyline, then maybe, yeah, Donovan Mitchell is the Rookie of the Year because he has a much better story. He's the 13th overall pick. But we're not talking about a story. We're talking about facts and stats. Ben Simmons is a better player this season. Ben Simmons has a better record this season. So if you're a Donovan Mitchell fan and you really think he deserves to win Rookie of the Year, I pose this question to you and I want you guys to answer it down below in the comment section below because I actually want to know why. Donovan Mitchell, is he Rookie of the Year because he's a better player than Ben Simmons? Or is he a Rookie of the Year because you feel that he deserves it because he is actually in his first rookie season? Do you feel like he deserves it because he was the 13th pick, so it's kind of a cool story? So why do you think he's deserving of Rookie of the Year? That's my question to you. And going back on my original thing, yes, I do believe it's a co-Rookie of the Year because I do feel like Donovan Mitchell deserves it because, first of all, he led a Utah Jazz team that was not even assumed to be making the playoffs this season. And also, he surprised a lot of people, and everybody knows the NBA loves the storyline. And third of all, it is true, this is his first season in the NBA. And whilst Ben Simmons didn't play in his first season, technically some people classify that as his first season. That's why I believe it should be a co. If it's not a co, Ben Simmons wins it, hands down in my opinion. I'll catch you guys in my next video. Let me know what you think down below in the comment section. I hope you guys to see you. Please hit the notification bell next to my name. Subscribe if you're new. Leave a like and comment what you think. I'll catch you guys in my next video. I'm out. Peace.